This is a brick, the smallest building block of most houses and apartments. This is the model of an atom. There are protons and neutrons in the center. Electrons revolve around it. The electrons are not what they seem here. They are very fast. The rotation speed of electrons around the nucleus is 2,200 kilometers per second, an incredible speed. If I could ride on these electrons, I could circle the world in 18 seconds. Atoms, the building blocks of me, are the building blocks of that brick, the building blocks of the air, and the building blocks of everything on Earth and in the sky. It is not easy to understand the smallness of atoms. Let's do a thought experiment. Try to imagine this. This is a sewing needle. Try imagining passing an elephant through its hole. Yes, it is not very difficult. It is something imaginable. Well, try this. This is Istanbul. Kadıköy district. If we expand Kadıköy a little, its population will be 700,000. If these 700,000 people were lined up side by side, if we assume that each person's shoulder width is 70 centimeters, how many kilometers long would a human strip be? There will be a human strip of 490 kilometers long. If people were lined up side by side from Istanbul, the distance would stretch past Ankara. Now, let's try to shrink the people lined up on these 490 kilometers. Let's make it so small that these people can fit within a strand of hair, in a straight line. 700,000 people fit into an area the thickness of a hair. Shrink every person to the size of an atom. 700,000 atoms arranged side by side would be as thick as a strand of hair. And that's why we don't see atoms. IBM is one of the world's largest computer technology companies. Their most important research area is information storage.
One atom at a time, and we want to explore how can we use atoms on surfaces to do computation and data storage.
They wanted to make a short movie from individual atoms to increase young people's interest in technology. To do this, they had to move the molecules one by one.
So to make this animation, we move molecules around one at a time to draw a little picture. And we save that picture and move on to the next frame to start to tell a story.
This difficult work requires extraordinary microscopes.
We're using two scanning tunneling microscopes to make this movie.
Microscopes magnified carbon monoxide molecules by 100 million times. What does it look like when the image gets this big? Nothing. Nothing is visible from vibrations traveling at 2,200 kilometers per second. We need to slow down shaking. We do this so that the atoms remain motionless.
We're working at a temperature of minus 260 something degrees centigrade. We do this so that these atoms hold still.
And these molecules were displaced with a copper needle at a distance of 1 nanometer.
Now we see the man that's built with all these carbon monoxide molecules, and then some of them we would have to shoot.
When the frames were combined, the world's first atomic film emerged, lasting 1.5 minutes. Let's look at some of it. As a result, it is currently impossible to build a molecule with individual atoms. It doesn't seem possible. The work is not an animated movie. It's a movie created solely from photographs. The atomic and subatomic world is so complex. Let me explain it this way. CERN, one of the world's largest science centers, is in Switzerland. Currently, 5,000 scientists are doing research on this subject. For 70 years, studies on atoms have been carried out here, but the mystery of the atomic and subatomic world has still not been completely solved. What is creative power? Creative power means being able to build with these incredibly small atoms. All atoms are from the same material: proton, neutron, and electron. For example, let me compare the carbon atom and the helium atom. There is only a numerical difference. There are 6 protons, 6 neutrons, and 6 electrons in carbon. In helium, there are 2 of each. many things are created from same thing. All 118 elements are products of the same factory. They are all made from the same materials. An incredibly colorful universe has been built and created with only numerical and formal differences. Electrons spin at 2,200 kilometers per second. Despite this incredible speed, they have maintained the same structure for billions of years. There is no chaos and confusion. If there was chaos in atoms, if there was no order and discipline, life on Earth would end in 3 to 5 seconds. It is not possible to manipulate atoms and molecules the way I am doing now. We can't add or remove individual atoms, or make them bond, or even touch a single atom. If we could manipulate atoms like this, we could easily create rare elements. This mercury atom is not an expensive element. It has 80 protons. When we reduce these 80 protons to 79, this element turns into gold. So we could manufacture gold. If we could remove one proton from its nucleus, mercury would turn into gold. The element of platinum, its atomic number is 78. If we could add a proton, it would be 79, and we would again obtain gold. This process is called nuclear transmutation. Very high-energy nuclear reactions are required to reduce or increase the number of protons. We need science centers like CERN, but it's dangerous. Can we change molecular structures like this? It's not possible to manipulate or create directly. These molecular structures are used in the pharmaceutical industry, all very critical. Since we cannot produce it ourselves, we have to find it from nature. Some examples. This is heparin, a chemical obtained only from cow intestines. It is used in medicine as an anticoagulant. No laboratory can synthesize this chemical that is produced in the cow's stomach. Digoxin is obtained from the foxglove plant. It is used in the treatment of heart failure and arrhythmia. Paclitaxel is obtained from yew tree bark. It is used in the treatment of breast, lung, and ovarian cancers and in chemotherapy. We can't make a copy. Artemisinin, obtained from the leaves of the Chinese datura plant. It is used in the treatment of malaria, a chemical created or produced in the bark of a tree or the leaf of a plant, cannot be replicated. Snake venom is very dangerous. It can kill in an instant. In the 1960s, Brazilian pharmacologist Sergio Henrique observed that a hypertension patient recovered after being bitten by a jararaca snake. When he investigated, he discovered the substance called captopril in the snake's venom. Later, this substance began to be used in high blood pressure and heart failure medications. When this substance in the venom mixes with blood, it can cause a very quick death. But the same substance cures when used at low dose. Barber's pygmy rattlesnake. This snake's venom contains the substance eptifibatide. It is used in the treatment of heart attack. It prevents blood clotting by preventing platelets from sticking to each other. The snake's poison is produced here, in the poison glands here. This is a robot snake. Imagine having a laboratory in its head. These are the formulas of the complex chemicals I've mentioned. What do you see when you look at them in detail? They are almost entirely composed of the same elements. They are unique and impossible to copy, works of art with the same atoms. There is no laboratory on Earth to build these molecular structures. Let's go 100 years into the future. The year is 2124. Technology has come a long way. We also realize that these chemicals can be synthesized in laboratories. What does this change? This shows that humanity, with its 2,500 years of scientific knowledge, has only been able to achieve imitations of God's art. Probably some scientists will receive Nobel Prizes for these chemicals that day. But even then, some will continue to ignore the power of creating these chemicals in the stomach of an animal or in the leaf of a plant. Some will continue to say, well, we do it too. So nature has must have learned to do it over billions of years. At the end of the short film, IBM summarizes what we need in one word,